The President,
veuillez vous asseoir.
Be seated. The court is now in session.
L'audience.
Mr. Duc Paris, could you please report
Paris,
to the court on the
pouvez-vous
presence of
dire
witness
à la chambre
Prayut.
Si le témoin
is she here?
Prayut est présent.
Duc Paris, Mr. President, Prayut
Monsieur le Président,
is here,
Madame
and
Prayut
she is at the waiting room,
présente,
awaiting
elle est dans
call
la salle d'attente.
By the chamber. Thank you, Mr. President.
En attendant que la chambre
the President, thank you, Mr.
à comparaître Paris. Devant elle. Le Président, je vous remercie, Monsieur Duc Paris.
Before we proceed with the hearing
avant
on the testimonies of Prayut,
la déposition
the chamber
de
would like to see whether parties have anything to raise
voudrait savoir si les parties souhaitent
at this moment
soulever
and that such applications or requests shall be addressed before the witness is summoned
et le cas
into
échéant,
the courtroom.
Counsel
for Inquiry, you may now proceed.
Je donne la parole à
good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honors.
Bonjour,
and good morning to everyone in
Madame
and around
juge,
the courtroom. I do have an application. I'll try to be brief. I'm mindful that we have a witness waiting, and hopefully
bref,
we can try to complete her testimony today.
Que cette déposition pourra prendre fin
the prosecution yesterday,
hier,
aside from asking leading questions throughout
des questions
the examination,
tout au long de
a topic which I will bring up shortly,
je vais y revenir.
Went, in our opinion, well beyond the scope of
à
the first
avis,
trial.
Cela dépasse largement
now,
le cadre du premier procès.
How could that be?
Comment cela se peut-il?
The prosecution, in their summary of this particular
dans
witness, noticed
résumé,
the particular paragraphs
a
in the closing order
le,
to which
un paragraphe
this
particulier de l'ordonnance de clôture,
witness was expected to testify.
À propos duquel
that summary
était censé déposer.
Was prepared
ce
well
résumé a été
before
établi
Your Honors issued your decision
bien avant que les juges
of 22 September 2001, severing the case, severing the closing order into several cases.
Des poursuites.
In looking at their summary,
à la lecture du
it would appear
résumé
that they anticipate
établi par l'accusation
eliciting testimony from the witness
apparemment, l'accusation
on paragraphs
entendait
168
faire déposer le témoin
to 177,
sur les paragraphes 178
178
à 177, 208
à 215,
205 à 215,
353
à 363,
740 à 744,
745
à 790. And they list the
749
topics.
À 790.
In your severance order, Your Honors,
dans l'ordonnance de disjonction, les
especially
juges ont
having attached
très clairement,
an annex,
notamment
which is
dans le cadre d'une
E124-7.2, informing the parties as to the nature of the first trial. And it's our understanding
les juges ont indiqué la portée du premier procès.
Save for the
selon
experts
nous,
who are entitled to testify about the entire closing order or anything within the entire closing order,
de clôture,
witnesses are limited
les témoins,
to the
eux,
first part of the first trial
aux questions
with the exception that if leave is sought
du premier procès,
for
avec une
exception, good cause and leave is granted.
À savoir
this
que
was brought up at one
si
of the meetings
il y a des raisons justifiées,
and it was
l'autorisation
and we understood that
cela a été soulevé lors
there must
de la première audience,
be an application for leave
nous,
and they must demonstrate why a witness would need to be questioned outside the scope of the first trial.
Le témoin sur des questions qui ne relèvent pas du premier procès. Le 17 novembre 2001,
you issued a memorandum,
les juges ont publié un mémorandum dans lequel ils indiquaient, et c'est le document 141,
les juges ont dit in the latter trials will be permitted.
Qu'il ne sera pas permis
so
d'examiner des points qui relèvent des procès ultérieurs.
On 28 November,
le 28 novembre,
you again issued a memorandum,
les juges ont publié un autre mémorandum, c'est le document 241.12.
And I'll quote this paragraph. The chamber reminds the co-prosecutors,
la chambre rappelle aux
co-procureurs that their examination shall be limited to facts relevant to the first trial.
Aux faits relevant
if it is considered that these witnesses
si
ought to, be, to also testify on matters beyond
doit également déposer sur des
the scope of case
002-01,
the co-prosecutors may make an oral application to the trial chamber,
peuvent faire une requête orale
who will
devant
determine
la chambre,
whether it is in the interest of effective trial management
s'il répond aux intérêts to hear d'une bonne these witnesses also on other topics. D'entendre le témoin sur
However,
d'autres points également.
The chamber
toutefois,
advises
la chambre
that such applications
indique
shall only,
que cette requête
rarely be granted.
Ne pourra être accordée que rarement. Cela date du 28 novembre 2011.
Then, on 29
ensuite,
November,
le 29 novembre 2011,
dans le document E145,
les juges ont publié un autre mémorandum.
Three of this
à la page 3 de ce dernier,
you also indicate
les juges
that no questioning
ont indiqué
on areas outside
que tout interrogatoire sur des questions ne relevant pas du présent procès
it would appear, Your Honors,
ne sera pas
that
permis.
You have been not just clear,
apparemment,
but crystal clear
les juges ont été
as to what you expect
non pas seulement clairs, mais extrêmement limpides quand
or what you expect from the parties concerning
ce que vous attendez de la part des parties
to be
au sujet
elicited or
des
deduced from the witnesses. And it is for the parties, I dare say, to self-manage themselves
c'est aux
and police themselves
de
to ensure that they stay within the confines of your orders and your decisions. It is our respectful submission that that is not the case, at least
juges.
With this particular witness.
Apparemment, ce n'est pas le cas
yesterday,
avec le témoin
there
présent
was
hier.
Testimony concerning dams.
Des dépositions ont été faites.
And it is very clear that
concernant les barrages,
it would appear, falls right outside
apparemment,
the parameters
of
the first
trial. Une déposition sort du cadre et des paramètres du premier procès.
There may be an explanation.
Cela
perhaps because
peut
the testimony
peut-être
was elicited in such a fashion that we were
position a été
totally unaware
obtenu
throughout the entire period of the questioning
d'une façon
as to what period
in time savoir,
the gentleman was eliciting questions.
On ne savait pas à quelle période l'accusation faisait allusion.
From this particular witness. It must be stressed that we realize
il convient de souligner
that prior to the severance orders, when the cases were being investigated,
l'ordonnance
statements
de disjonction pendant l'instruction, ce témoin
the investigators
a fait des déclarations.
At the time obviously were not aware
les enquêteurs, à l'époque,
that down the road there would be a severance.
Ne savaient pas qu'il y aurait
so
plus tard une disjonction.
May contain areas,
il se peut donc que les déclarations contiennent des informations précieuses pour l'accusation ou d'autres parties et qui ne relèvent pas du cadre du premier
but simply because it's in a
dossier.
Statement, it doesn't mean
ce n'est pas parce qu'un élément se trouve dans une déclaration qu'il peut
reference to
y être fait allusion et que des questions peuvent être posées à ce sujet sans qu'une autorisation ne soit demandée auparavant
001.
Si ce point ne relève pas des paramètres du dossier numéro 1. Nous avons une demande à vous soumettre respectueusement. Il s'agirait d'ordonner à toutes les parties de respecter les décisions de la Chambre. Il y a aujourd'hui trois procureurs, il y en a trois aussi hier, je pense. Si et on peut penser qu'ils se coordonnent. D'où ma question, est-ce qu'il s'agit d'un plan calculé de sortir du cadre de ce procès, ou bien s'agit-il d'un simple manquement à l'obligation de diligence raisonnable? Dans les deux cas, ceci nous oblige à perdre du temps à nous lever pour contester des objections. Du côté de la défense, en plus, D'aucuns ont l'impression que nous voulons faire obstruction à la procédure. Or, tel n'est pas le cas. Il sera beaucoup, la gestion du processus sera plus efficace si les parties se limitent aux paramètres fixés. Lorsqu'un témoin vient avant sa déposition, il faudrait que la personne interrogeant le témoin fasse une offre de preuve quant au paragraphe au sujet duquel ils entendent recueillir des dépositions. Cela évitera que la procédure ne soit interrompu constamment par des objections. Je n'ai pas soulevé d'objection hier parce que je ne voulais pas prendre la parole. Je le fais maintenant dans l'espoir que l'accusation pourra revoir et réorienter son interrogatoire de façon à le rationaliser, le rendre plus efficace et conforme aux instructions des juges. Dans le cas contraire, je vais bien sûr élever des objections répétées et énergique. La même chose vaut pour les questions orientées. Hier, plusieurs questions orientées ont été posées. La question tenait pour acquis des faits qui sont peut-être dans la déclaration. Peut-être que certains pensent que si des éléments sont dans une déclaration, cela peut être utilisé comme fait pour poser une question, même si les faits ne viennent pas du témoin lui-même. Nous contestons que soient posées des questions orientées, surtout lorsque ce sont des questions suggestives. Voici mes observations. Je vous remercie d'avoir pris le temps de m'entendre. Si l'accusation souhaite répondre, aucun problème. Mais si elle le fait, j'aimerais entendre de la part des juges des explications quant à la manière dont les barrages relèveraient des paramètres du premier procès. On me donne les paragraphes pertinents et la période pertinente. Merci.
The President, International Co-Prosecutor, you may now proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
And I will try to be brief.
J'essaierai d'être bref.
I certainly agree that we want to
Je
avoid interruptions,
qu'il faut éviter
and I think this objection in speech was entirely unnecessary if counsel had
inutile.
Himself engaged in the due diligence of reading these sections of the closing order
diligence raisonnable en lisant les sections de l'ordonnance de clôture qui concerne le dossier 002-1.
A large focus of our examination and one of the principal reasons that this witness was included
in our list
was because of her role as a member of the sector committee and a district secretary. As the court is aware, paragraphs 64 to 71 of the closing order, which deal with national administrative structures, as well as paragraphs 72 through 112, which deal with communication structure,
le système de communication. Tout cela relève du cadre du présent dossier. Les faits énoncés dans ces paragraphes concernent précisément l'autorité des zones, des secteurs et des districts, ainsi que la diffusion des instructions et politiques du parti depuis le centre vers les zones, secteurs et districts, ainsi que la communication des informations depuis les communes, districts et secteurs vers les zones, du bas vers le haut.
To give you an example,
Je vais prendre un exemple. C'est le paragraphe 68. On trouve ce qui suit.
Paragraphe 68 of the closing order.
Paragraphe 68 de l'ordonnance de clôture.
Implementation of decisions of the central and standing committees was performed by the secretaries of the zones and the autonomous sectors. Policies and instructions of the central and standing committees were disseminated to the zone and autonomous sector secretaries, who in turn would disseminate them among sector and district level secretaries for implementation. Conversely, these sub-districts reported back up to the district committees, which reported to the sector committees, which in turn reported to the zone committees. And I could continue on reading from here, but the point is that as part of the plan for this trial, the trial chamber has requested that the proof be made regarding the general administrative structures, who had authority to do what within as between zones, sectors, districts, and how reporting of information and reporting of instructions work. In order to cover those topics, obviously, we need to get into some details.
Bien entendu,
we do not intend to go into specific details of crimes that are not part of this case,
pas du
but
dossier,
it is obviously necessary in order to properly inform the court as to how a district secretary reported up above to get into a little bit of information about the subjects that were reported. So to specifically respond to counsel's question, the reason dams were brought up is because part of this witness's statement before was on the reporting of what went on at dams and the hardships that people faced there, including starvation and numbers of deaths, and how that information was reported up to the upper echelon. And that is the reason that we are uncovering that. We do not intend to get into details of dams or worksites that are part of
des chantiers ou des barrages qui relèvent des procès ultérieurs. Nous utilisons ces informations pour prouver les faits qui relèvent de la structure administrative et des communications. J'espère avoir éclairé ainsi la Chambre.
Obviously, in addition to those subjects, we will have some questions for this witness related to the first and second force movements. I will have some questions related to
le transfert forcé première
et deuxième
phase.
J'aurai aussi des questions sur l'Assemblée des représentants du peuple, one of the subjects that is included in this part of the case.
Qui relève également de cette partie
the only other thing I would add to this is that for any witness, I think it is important
quel que soit le témoin, il faut pouvoir recueillir
witness,
des informations de contexte sur ce témoin.
Located,
il faut savoir
before,
où se trouvait la personne avant et pendant la période du Cambodge démocratique, quel était
so
le statut de la personne, afin de bien
those
mettre
les
positions
have,
en contexte.
This witness, we will do that within the time that has been allocated.
Nous allons
and I think
le
this
faire
objection would have been entirely unnecessary if counsel had simply read the relevant sections of the closing order.
Et la partie adverse pourrait plus contenter de lire
the second reason that we wanted to call this witness is something we will not be covering. And that is the issue of the purge of the central zone. Because that is part of a crime that is part, currently not part of this case. And certainly that was a significant reason that we wanted to hear from this witness because she was one of the cadres from the southwest zone who was sent up to the central zone to take over positions, districts and sector positions when the existing cadres were purged.
Now,
there will be some need, it's impossible for her to tell her story
il est impossible
without touching
pour cette dame de raconter
briefly
son histoire,
on that,
sans
but we will not be
questions.
Getting into details
nous
about
pas
the arrests,
ces questions de façon approfondie,
the broad purge
les
of the zone. That is obviously the subject of another trial.
De la zone.
But
cela relève de
in the sense
ultérieurs.
That it is necessary to understand the testimony and that it relates to the structural issues and reporting issues, that would be the only extent we would cover subjects
et de
like that.
Il faudra examiner ces questions. J'espère que mes indications sont utiles.
Le président, legal lawyer for the civil parties, may
je donne la parole à la partie civile.
Après
quoi, nous entendrons la défense de Yeng Sari.
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
Yes, Mr. President.
La partie civile partage bien sûr
we
les soucis
of course
de notre confrère de la défense
support
de voir les
the
règles
concerns of the defense, that is to say, to abide by the rules.
But
we, however, believe that the co-prosecutors have not overstepped the scope in their questioning by limiting themselves, of course, to the confines of the sub-trial. However, I would like the rules to be applied strictly to everyone.
De mémoire, les parties civiles,
and as far as I remember, the civil parties are subjected to the same rules as the witnesses. And I have an example here that troubles me. I remember Clanfit, for example. The prosecutors and the civil parties limited themselves to the confines of the first sub-case without bringing up the purges, whereas the defense overstepped, we believe, the confines of this first sub-case. So we would therefore like the rules to be applied to all parties in terms of questioning, including the defense.
President, Council for Yang Sirri, please.
Thank you very much, Mr. President, Your Honours.
Beaucoup,
what we heard was a rather clever excuse for going into areas outside
un prétexte pour examiner des questions qui ne relèvent
paragraph
pas
7
du présent procès.
Makes it very clear.
Le paragraphe 7 est clair.
Work sites,
aucune
goes
coopérative,
on.
Aucun
what
chantier,
part
etc.
Of work sites does the prosecutor not understand? They say, well, this was for purely administrative purposes.
Que
we want to show that there's
communication.
Administrative. And then the question begins,
et ensuite, how d'autres questions
people were
sont posées,
eating, how much food there was.
Sur la ration alimentaire.
Did you see them in a very leading fashion?
Puis des questions orientées, est-ce consistant à dire, est-ce que vous avez eu des gens tomber malades ou mourir?
What does that have to do with,
quel rapport cela a-t-il
avec structure?
Les structures administratives?
Nothing.
Aucun
what
rapport.
The attempt is to get inch in and to begin talking about specific work sites.
De commence,
because
essaye
once they get into that
de commencer
area,
à parler de certains chantiers
it then invites
précis.
The other side to
car
get into
à ce moment-là, la partie adverse devra
now,
aussi
I understand that
traiter
they have
de ces
some
questions.
Problems. There are the way
l'accusation est confrontée à des problèmes.
The severance order is drafted and the way the closing order is drafted and that you need context. But at what point does context stop and we go into substance?
Mais there où est la limite entre problem, le contexte et le fond?
I could care less if the prosecution has the authority
si
or the right to go into all the areas. I just
want to
know from the beginning
soit,
what it is.
Because
it puts us at a disadvantage.
Retourne,
and to
position
simply say, well, we're just talking about the reporting system. And in the process, you begin using matters that are in the statement in a leading fashion that goes into the substance of areas that are strictly prohibited.
Now maybe they, dans la déclaration
maybe
et qui ne relève pas du présent
it's hard to draw that distinction, to draw the line.
C'est peut-être une distinction difficile à établir.
The better practice
mais
is to say
le mieux
we're going to be touching upon these areas.
Serait de dire
and this is how
nous
far
allons
we're going to go.
Traiter de ces questions.
Do we have permission?
Est-ce que nous sommes autorisés
otherwise,
à aller
it causes
jusque-là.
Us to object.
Sinon, nous devrons
and this was
une
a good faith effort to bring this matter to some sort of a resolution.
En toute bonne foi,
but
proposer
if the trial
une solution, mais si la Chambre pense que l'accusation peut
reasons,
traiter de ces questions pour des
then
raisons
I
de
the right
contexte,
to make
alors
my record
je me réserve
by objecting
le droit
every time I
de
think
contester
that it's
une question à chaque fois que je pense qu'elle ne relève
thank
pas
you.
Du présent procès. Merci.
Counsel for Nunchie, you may
proceed.
I see you're very eager to discuss this topic. I just want to take this opportunity
oui.
To support my colleague.
J'aimerais profiter de l'occasion pour appuyer ce que dit mon collègue.
The President, could you please hold on a moment?
Attendez un instant, s'il vous plaît.
The President, before we proceed to counsel for Nguyen Chi, I would like to hand over to Judge Sylvia Cartwright,
la parole à Madame la Juge Cartwright
to clarify things a little bit.
Quelques précisions.
Thank you.
Je vous remercie.
Counsel for Nguyen Chi, could you please be on your feet?
Yes, thank you, President. Counsel for Nguyen Chi, this is not in any way intended to cut off your submission. I just want to clarify the procedure for future occasions. If counsel, as has happened this morning, for Yang Sari makes a submission, it should then be answered by the prosecutor, the civil, the co-lead lawyers, other defense counsel who wish to support or clarify, and then counsel for Yang Sari will have the final right of reply, knowing what everyone has to say. So I just want to clarify that procedure for the future. For the present time, I gather that you support the submission of Yang Sari, so that is taken into account. And if counsel for Khieu Samphan wish to support or oppose, perhaps they could say so. But that means we then have to give counsel for Yang Sari a further say, which we want to avoid having to occur. So could you please limit your comments now, unless you've got some extended matters that you wish to say, simply to support or otherwise, as the case may be. And this is simply to clarify the procedure for future occasions of this nature. Thank you.
Le reste de la procédure. Je vous remercie.
All I wanted to do was support the submissions made by my colleague. I think we need clear parameters, instructions of what is allowed and what is not allowed.
Nous avons besoin de paramètres de limites claires quant à ce qui est autorisé, ce qui n'est pas lors des interrogatoires, en particulier lorsque l'on parle d'événements qui se sont produits après 1975. Je vous remercie.
La défense de Monsieur Khieu Samphan est évidemment d'accord, solidaire avec le reste de la défense.
Khieu Samphan is in full support.
And I presume, Mr. Carnavas, you have nothing further in response.
J'imagine que vous n'avez rien
no,
à
no,
ajouter.
Your Honor. Thank you for inquiring.
Non, Madame la juge, mais merci de me poser la question.
The President.
Le Président.
Thank you, Defense Counsel, for your application to the chamber to confirm the procedure.
Remercions la défense pour cette demande de précision quant à la
On
procédure.
On this particular subject, yesterday, as the president of the chamber,
hier,
we
en tant que président de la chambre,
advised the prosecution very clearly.
Clairement indiqué à l'accusation.
And in addition, I also advise.
J'ai donné des indications claires à l'accusation et j'ai aussi rappelé aux parties
in discussing the subject matters before the chamber and we has so far directed parties to focus
qu'il faut
on the subject matters
respecter les sujets déjà établis pour le premier procès
taking into account the facts
tout en tenant compte
in the sovereign orders
des dispositions de l'ordonnance de mini trial
as indicated in document E124/7.2 this is the scope of the alleged facts
qui détermine ou qui est rappelle la portée des faits allégués
examine
and le procès
bring up evidence relating to the facts set out in the scope of this trial
prévu par ce cette écriture que je viens de mentionner
known as case 002/01
pour le donc ce mini procès connu sous le nom de procès 002/1
secondly the chamber wishes to advise the parties that parties involved
la chambre souhaite aussi rappeler aux parties
examination of the alleged facts it should be in orders as set out in paragraphs indicated in document E124/7.2 so the examination of evidence should be in the order of the paragraph enumerated in this document
qu'il faut suivre l'exposé des faits
and the facts set out in those paragraphs have been actually clear because they are the titles of the documents, for example, the administrative structure, military structure, the facts relating to the joint criminal enterprise, the policy and the forced movement in phase one and phase two. And there are several other alleged facts in those paragraphs and the parameters have been set very clear in order from the small number to the bigger number. So once again, the chambers would like to advise the parties to be focused on the questions and make sure that the questions are simple and specific so that the witness can answer the question and the chamber can also trace the development of questions and facts that
evolve.
So again, the chamber wishes to remind the parties to be focused when putting questions to the witness as directed by the chamber so far.
Les orientations données par la chambre.
On a separate issue,
un autre point maintenant.
In certain issue, parties may have dwelt on other points which are considered irrelevant. However, there are certain areas which are also useful in the discussion of the subject matter.
Mais qui sont pertinents pour
and the chamber takes into
la
account every question the parties ask. And
the chamber will
make effort to follow the line of questioning whether or not they remain in the parameter of the subject matter. I understand that the facts involve the crimes that took place across Cambodia. And of course, these involve the historical backgrounds, for example, the history of the Democratic Kampuchea, which we have already heard the testimony by witness, and Communist Party of Kampuchea was even established long before 1975. So there has been a lot of issues which the chamber wishes to remind parties again that they should be focused when putting questions. It should be straightforward and within the parameter of case 02/01. And to make this even clearer, I would like to hand over to Judge Sylvia Cartwright to add.
La parole à Madame la Juge Cartwright pour quelques clarifications
supplémentaires. Thank you, President.
Madame la Juge Cartwright.
The President has outlined the general approach.
Le président vient de rappeler l'approche
the court will take in relation to the current trial. Specifically in relation to this objection,
en particulier en ce qui a trait à l'objection qui a été soulevée,
the court considers that the questions put to this witness concerning issues which are not strictly within the historical segment
of
the trial can be put, so long as they relate strictly to issues of the structure communications, but do not go into the substance of those issues, which will be explored in later trials.
Now,
having said that, it's necessary to remind counsel that it is vital that they not put questions to this witness which allow her to go into the substance or encourage her to go into the substance. And certainly the chamber agrees that leading questions, leading questions of any variety should not be put to this witness. It's perhaps unfortunate that this witness's knowledge spans such a wide time frame. But it is important that we take advantage of her presence to cover all topics of which she has knowledge, which are directly relevant to this trial. So, Mr. Carnavis, I hope that clarifies matters for you. The Chamber will endeavour to control the questions as much as it can to avoid objections from counsel which tend to take longer to resolve. So, prosecutors, please bear in mind these comments
and
that the Chamber will endeavour strictly to control this. As to the co-lead lawyer's submission that the rules apply to everyone, that is of course correct. However, questions put by defence do tend to more latitude is normally allowed to questions put by the defence because they are trying usually to undermine what the prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers are attempting to achieve through a witness. However, that is not to say that those questions can stray beyond the parameters of this trial. Thank you. Thank you, President.
Thank you, Your Honor. Says
the President. Je vous remercie, Madame la Juge.
Now the court officer is instructed to
huissier d'audience, veuillez
bring the
faire entrer
witness
le témoin
before the chamber. The President. Good morning, Ms. Prakyut.
Bonjour, Madame Prakyut.
Today, the Chamber will continue the hearing of your testimony.
La Chambre
and before we hand over to the prosecution, we wish to, advise the parties that when you ask questions, you have to make sure that your mic is being activated, and please make sure that you pause a bit before you start the next question so that the translation gets through properly.
Aux parties de faire une pause entre les réponses et les questions pour que l'interprétation puisse suivre.
So that parties involved in the proceeding understand the content of the question and answers.
Puisse bien saisir la nature des questions et des réponses.
Now, I hand over to the prosecution to put question to the witness. You may now proceed. Co-prosecutor.
Le co-procureur.
Good morning, Mrs. Witness.
Bonjour,
I madame. Would like to continue my line of questioning.
Nous maintenant poursuivre l'interrogatoire que nous avions commencé hier.
Before the 17th of 1975,
avant le 17 avril
where
1975,
did you live and what did you do?
Où habitiez-vous et quelle était votre profession?
Answer. Before 17 April 1975, I cannot remember, well, I did not know where I was residing at that time.
Je ne me souviens pas où j'habitais à l'époque.
I forget, I don't know.
Je regrette.
It has been such a long time, so I could not remember it.
Je ne me souviens plus.
Question. Did you live in Takeo or Kampot province at that time? Do you recall
dans
that?
De Kampot? Vous souvenez-vous?
Answer.
Réponse.
Before 17 of April,
avant le 17 avril 75,
I cannot remember, I don't know whether I was residing in Takeo or Kampot province.
Je ne me souviens pas si j'habitais à Takeo ou à Kampot.
Question.
Question.
So So after the 17th of April 1975,
après le 17 avril,
did you notice that the place where you were living had more new people coming in? Answer. Before the 17th of April 1975, the population in my area where I lived did not arrive.
Le 17 avril 1975, la population de là où j'habitais n'a pas augmenté.
Question. So I first ask you where you lived before the 17th of April 1975. Then after 1975, after the 17th of April 1975, I would like to know whether or not you noticed the increase of the number of people in your area. Answer.
Réponse.
After 17th of April 1975, I did not notice whether there was an influx of new people to my area. I did not take any notice of that.
Je n'ai rien remarqué de la sorte.
Question. So did you notice new faces, I mean the new people who had never lived in your areas, did you notice any newcomers to your area? Answer. Well, at that time, I lived in that village and I did not see any new faces.
I
only noticed that the people in my neighborhood live as normal.
Les gens de mon voisinage vivaient normalement.
Question. So can you tell us
question.
Whether or not there were group of people who are called the 17 April people?
Pouvez-vous me dire s'il y avait des gens appelés peuple du 17 avril?
Back then, I did not hear about the 17 April people.
I did not see those
people who are called the 17 April people. I did not pay attention. I am not making an excuse. That was the truth. That's what I knew. At the place where I was living in that time, there were no people known as the 17 April people. Back then, I did not even pay attention to it.
Je n'ai pas porté attention à cela.
Question. You said you did not pay attention to the influx of new people, but I would like to know now if you have heard of the 17 April people.
J'aimerais savoir, avez-vous entendu parler du peuple du 17 avril?
Correction, interpreter.
Réponse.
Yes, I have. Oui. I have heard of the 17
April. J'ai entendu parler April du peuple du 17 people. Avril.
Question. When did you first hear the 17 April people?
Quand avez-vous
Answer.
Entendu?
Sometime in 1976.
Réponse. En 1976.
Question.
Question.
In the mobile unit, which you
dans le groupe mobile
informed the chamber yesterday, you said you managed a mobile unit of around 200 to 300 members. So can you tell us whether or not there were new people or 17 April people in that unit?
Membres du peuple du 17 avril dans cette unité.
In the mobile unit I supervise, later on there were new members, new people coming in this mobile unit.
Il y avait de nouvelles personnes plutôt dans cette unité que je dirigeais.
Did you know where those new people come from?
Question. Saviez-vous d'où venaient ces nouvelles personnes?
Answer. When they came to stay with the mobile unit I supervised, They came from the village. Actually, there are a few villages. They send those people to work in the mobile unit, but I do not know as to what villages send those people to work in my mobile unit.
Question,
did you know that people were evacuated from cities from Phnom Penh? Response, yes, I do. I heard that people were evacuated from cities. However, I felt that it was none of my business. I only heard of it. And I was not interested in the news, although I heard of such evacuation. We observed that there were evacuees, but at my location, I was not interested in this evacuation.
Question.
Can you tell us what the upper echelon did with this evacuation? Response, I have no idea.
If I may be heard,
réponse, je n'en sais rien.
Before the gentleman
la défense
begins asking questions about
avant
the upper echelon, he needs to lay a foundation that she actually had access to the upper echelon, wherever the upper echelon may be,
dame avait accès
as opposed to
à
assuming a fact
où qu'il se trouve,
that has not been established.
Car il s'agit de fait qui n'a pas été établi.
The President, Co-Prosecutor, you may now proceed. Prosecutor,
le co-procureur.
Upper echelon here is referring to
lorsque
the quote from the statement from the witness who indicated that upper echelon asked her to do some things, and we have not put question to that particular portion. We just asked her to see what was it like. Counsel for inquiry, you may proceed.
Mr. President, as I noted yesterday, simply because it's in a statement, it doesn't mean that the gentleman gets to use what's in the statement as a basis for his question in formulating the question. He needs to elicit the testimony from the witness. So if I may assist the gentleman, he should ask with whom she was communicating above, at what level,
réponse,
up to which point.
Et il faut demander
and
avec quel supérieur
then he can proceed. But to give this term upper echelon, because she uses it or may have been fed to her, may have been fed to her by one of the investigators, that is not sufficient.
A peut-être été soufflé au
so he needs to establish a foundation as to how far she went up
il faut demander au
and to at what level
quel
she was communicating with. And if she wants to call those people upper echelon, then at least now we have a ceiling and we have a proper definition of what she means by upper echelon. Because later on, Your Honors, you will be asked
tard,
to draw some conclusions. The prosecution will have you believe the upper echelon may be at the very, very top. I don't know. But I think in order to have a proper record, we need to make sure that the testimony comes
clair,
from the witness, not from some statement
given,
and she gave four statements, incidentally, all of which are not necessarily identical. And we don't know whether she was actually fed that term or that was the term that she came up with. So I would appreciate if the testimony came from the witness's mouth
soufflé
through proper questioning,
il faut donc
open-ended,
les
who,
questions
what,
dans les
where,
voulues,
why,
de
how,
façon ouverte,
explain, describe.
Quoi, comment,
thank
pourquoi,
you.
Etc. Merci.
Response, the objection is not sustained.
L'objection
co-prosecutor may proceed.
Je donne la parole au co-procureur.
co-prosecutor. Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Witness, do you still remember
Madame,
the question I just put to you?
Vous vous souvenez de la question que je
what
vous ai posée?
Were you asked to do by the upper echelon?
Qu'est-ce que l'échelon supérieur vous
response
a demandé de faire?
I don't quite remember the question, but
je ne me
to me,
de la question.
I worked at a lower level,
quant à moi,
and
à un niveau
people
inférieur
were evacuated from other cities.
Des gens
in
ont été
fact,
des
I, do not, I did not know much about this evacuation,
je pas
and
chose.
I did not know whether this matter were discussed
je
at the upper
si
echelon or not. And I am talking telling the truth, and I am not here to give my version of excuses. That's all I can tell.
Ce n'est pas une excuse, c'est la vérité.
Question.
Question.
To the best of your knowledge, do you know how evacuation took place?
Comment
response.
L'évacuation s'est
I saw people were walking on the street.
J'ai vu des gens marcher.
However, I did not know how they were evacuated from the first place, from the cities. Although I noted, I
des villes.
Saw them were walking, feeling the road.
Comme je l'ai dit, je les ai vus
again,
marcher.
I'm not making any excuses.
Nouveau,
I'm telling the truth.
Je dis la vérité.
And as in my capacity as a member of the lower level echelon, I
de l'échelon inférieur.
Did not know what happened at the upper echelon
et
level.
Je ne sais pas, je ne savais pas ce qui se passait au niveau supérieur.
Sorry.
Thank you. Question.
Question.
You said you saw people walking on
que vous avez vu
some
des
roads.
Gens marcher
did
sur
you
la route.
Notice the condition of those people?
Dans quel état étaient ces gens?
Response.
Réponse.
I think there were some difficulties or hardship those people endured because it is a common sense that people could have been experiencing some hardship.
C'est une question de bon sens. Il va de soi que ces gens avaient des difficultés.
Question: can you please elaborate further on
question,
this?
Pouvez-vous apporter quelques
about the hardship,
sujet,
how was it like?
Au sujet des difficultés de ces gens.
Response.
Réponse.
People who were walking with children in the sun,
qui marchaient
I think
en plein soleil avec des enfants.
Difficult.
Je crois
that's
que c'était
all I can tell.
Pénible. Voilà tout ce que je peux dire.
Question. How did
question.
The people go about on those roads? I mean, how did they get from one place to another?
Comment est-ce que les gens se déplaçaient sur
response.
La route?
Réponse. Some took their bicycles
certains
or motorbikes.
Étaient
some
à vélo,
were on foot.
Certains à mobilette et d'autres à pied.
Thank you. Question.
Question. Merci.
Did you see any people be at the place to guard the evacuees?
Avez-vous vu des gens
response.
Qui surveillaient les personnes évacuées?
I did not
réponse.
Observe this carefully. I did not
je
know
n'ai pas
whether there were
vraiment
any
fait attention.
Security
je ne sais pas s'il y avait des agents de sécurité
or armed people to
ou des gens armés
guard them
qui étaient là pour surveiller
because I was
ces gens.
Not very interested in this.
Je
I had another fish to fry. for example,
d'autres tâches
doing farming.
À effectuer. Par exemple, les tâches agricoles.
So I was not interested in the evacuees. I was committed to assisting my own people in my location, doing farming and
les gens là où moi je me trouvais,
going about
je
my
me
other business.
À des tâches agricoles et autres.
Question. Do you think those people were willing to
question.
Be evacuated?
Est-ce que vous pensez Response. Que ces gens étaient évacués
I have no idea.
Volontairement?
President, if I may be heard very briefly,
la défense.
I was cautioned not to ask the witness, I believe it was yesterday, to speculate. This was a question calling for speculation.
Demander aux témoins de spéculer. Cette
what
question
the people
est une invitation
thought,
à
what she
spéculer.
The people thought.
On demande aux témoins
It's
de
calling
dire ce que les gens pensaient à son avis.
C'est ce qu'on not to ask those sorts of questions.
Appelle à amener quelqu'un à se lancer dans des spéculations. J'aimerais que l'on ordonne à l'accusation de ne pas procéder ainsi. Le
President, objection is sustained.
L'objection est retenue.
Prosecutor is now advised
L'accusation
to put question that is not calling for speculation.
Est prié de ne pas poser de questions qui sont une invitation à se
Thank
livrer
you,
à des spéculations.
Mr. President.
L'accusation. Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Question. During the period when you were working in Kampot,
Lorsque vous traveilliez
Did you
dans
know
la province
that
de Kampot,
people were evacuated from one location
est-ce que vous saviez que des
another?
Gens étaient évacués
Response.
Et transférés d'un endroit
I
à un autre?
I did work in Kampot province, but I had no knowledge
Effectivement,
of
je travaillais à
Kampot, people being evacuated.
Mais je ne savais pas que des
It
gens
was
étaient
the business
évacués.
Of my boss, my superior, because
Cela
I was just an assistant.
Quant à moi, j'étais une simple assistante auprès de mon supérieur.
J'aidais
dans son travail.
Evacuation of people from Kampot to other locations, it was none of beyond my knowledge.
Je n'ai pas eu connaissance d'un transfert
the truth.
De population
no lies.
Depuis Kampot vers un autre endroit. Et ça, c'est la vérité. Ce n'est pas un
I
mensonge.
Work there. There was a district
là-bas.
Secretary,
Il y avait
and I was helping him with his daily
moi,
work, and he made the decision,
C'est cette
which
qui
was
prenait
beyond
les
my
décisions
knowledge.
Lesquelles échappaient
Question,
à ma
connaissance. You said
Question.
You had no idea of when evacuation took place, but do you
l'évacuation a eu lieu?
Agree that there was such evacuation?
Mais est-ce que vous convenez
Response,
qu'une telle évacuation
yes, I do.
A bel et bien eu lieu? Réponse, oui.
Thank you. Question.
Question.
Was there any cooperative being established in Kampot province?
Des coopératives ont-elles été mises en
Response.
Place dans la province de Kampot?
Yes, it was.
Réponse, oui.
Thank you. Question.
Question.
When was the cooperative established in the first place.
À quel moment a-t-on
Response,
mis en place une
I cannot
coopérative.
Recall it. It was a
Réponse,
long time ago.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
I
C'était
don't
il
remember
y a bien longtemps.
The month or the year in which such cooperative was established. I did not take note of this date and time passed by.
Je n'ai
it
pas
was so
noté
long
cette
ago.
Date.
And
Cela
I'm afraid
bien longtemps.
My memory is very poor now when
et
I am aging.
Je suis âgé à présent et ma mémoire n'est plus très bonne.
Thank you. Question.
Question.
You said that you don't remember the dates. It's fine, but was it happening when you were still in Comport that the cooperatives were established?
Response,
yes, it was during the time when I was in Comport district, not in Comport district. Question, do you know who ordered the establishment of such cooperatives?
À votre connaissance, qui a ordonné la mise en place de ces coopératives?
I don't know who created the cooperatives, but we and the chief of the district would be called to
moi-même, ainsi que
execute the cooperatives establishment plan. And I did not know how the decision was made and how it was created. I was only informed that cooperatives would be created in our district. And we had to follow.
Dans mon district.
Thank you. Co-prosecutor, Mr. President, I have no further questions to put, but I would like my colleague to proceed with further questions.
With your leave, pour la suite de
Mr. President,
si
International Co-Prosecutor, you may now proceed.
Je donne à présent la parole au co-procureur international.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Good Monsieur morning. Président. Bonjour.
Before I get to any questions of substance,
questions
I want to ask you
fond,
whether you remember giving a number
si
of interviews
avoir
to representatives of the court back in 2009.
Des représentants du tribunal en 2009.
Response. Are you talking about the interview they conducted with me?
Est-ce que vous parlez des entretiens qui ont été effectués?
Yes. Do you remember giving interviews to investigators from the Office of Co-Investigating Judges back in 2009? Two or more years ago.
2009, il y a deux ans ou plus de cela.
Response. Yes, I do.
Oui.
Did you tell the truth during those interviews?
Avez-vous dit la vérité au cours de ces entretiens?
Réponse. Yes, I did.
Oui.
And you were interviewed
Question.
Four times, is that
Vous
correct?
Vous avez été entendu à quatre reprises, n'est-ce pas?
Réponse. Yes, it is.
Oui.
Each time Question. You were interviewed, were you
Lors
given an opportunity to review a written record
eu l'occasion
of your
d'examiner
interview?
Le procès-verbal de votre audition?
Réponse. Yes, I was. I was read
oui.
out loud.
On m'a donné lecture.
Well, actually, I did not read the interviews because I could not read and write, but I was read out.
Je n'ai pas lu moi-même parce que je ne sais pas lire, mais on m'en a donné lecture.
So the interviews were read to you
on vous a donné
by the investigators. Is that correct?
Du procès-verbal. Ce sont les enquêteurs qui l'ont fait, n'est-ce pas?
Response, yes,
réponse,
it is.
C'est
After
exact.
Each interview, the content of the
audition,
interview would be read out to
on
me.
On m'a donné lecture du résumé de mes déclarations.
And did you put your
Question.
Thumbprint
Avez-vous apposé votre
on the pages of those interviews
sur les
to confirm
pages
their accuracy?
Pour confirmer la véracité des informations qui y étaient contenues?
Réponse. Yes, I did.
Oui.
Did you
Question.
Recently have an opportunity
Avez-vous
to have those statements read to you when you came to the court to testify.
Lorsque vous êtes venu déposer au tribunal. Réponse.
Response. Yes, I did. Some questions were read out to me again, but I don't remember the detail, but I remember that the détails. Questions were read out to me.
Je sais cependant qu'on m'a donné lecture il y a peu de certaines questions.
Was it this week that your prior statements were read to you, or was it when you first came to the court last month in December?
La première fois que vous êtes venu au tribunal, à savoir au mois de décembre dernier.
Réponse, last week.
C'était la semaine dernière.
And when
question.
Those statements were read to you,
lorsqu'on
did you notice any information that was incorrect?
Avez-vous relevé des informations inexactes?
Réponse. No, I didn't.
Non.
I was read out all the questions
on m'a donné lecture
and
de toutes
I could
les
confirm
questions
that they are correct.
Et j'ai pu confirmer que cela était exact.
I want to start by just
question.
Going back to clarify where it was you lived and the positions you held from the time you joined the revolution in 1970 through the democratic Kampuchea regime.
Vous avez rejoint les rangs de la
revolution, you testified yesterday that you joined the revolution in
1970.
Where were you living
la revolution
in 1970 when you joined the revolution?
Où viviez-vous à ce moment-là? Réponse.
Please be informed that I joined the revolution in 1970 when I was living in Kampot.
À ce moment-là, j'habitais à Kampot.
And then Takao province.
Et
I only lived in those two provinces when I joined the revolution.
Uniquement dans ces deux provinces.
Later on in 1977, I moved to the central zone at sector 42 where I stayed for 2 months.
J'y suis resté 2 mois.
When my husband was arrested, I returned.
Après l'arrestation de mon mari,
in 1970, when I was residing in Takao, I did not do anything. Although I joined the revolution, when I was in Kampot, I later on was promoted to be the sixth
mais ensuite,
member
à Kampot,
of
j'ai été promu et suis
the
devenu
sector.
Le membre numéro 6 du secteur.
And that position was promoted to me in Kampot,
c'est à Kampot
and I was in the position
in
charge of women affairs
je suis devenu
in
responsable
1975
des affaires
later
des
on
femmes en 1975.
I left Kampot
plus tard,
for
j'ai quitté Kampot
Kampuncham
pour gagner
after
Kampuncham.
Being in Kampot for 3 years,
ce,
and I spent 2 months in Kampuncham.
J'ai passé 2 mois à Kampuncham.
After that situation, I returned.
Ensuite, je suis rentré.
Okay.
Question.
Thank you for that. I'd like to
merci.
Go through each place step by step, if I can.
Les différents
when you joined the revolution in 1970, did I understand you say that you were still living in Takao
bien dit que
at
vous
that
viviez
time?
Encore à
is that
Takao,
correct?
N'est-ce pas?
Response, yes, it is.
Effectivement.
And were you still
question.
Living in Tramkok district,
est-ce que
the place
vous
you were born?
Au district de Tramkok, votre lieu de naissance?
Response.
Réponse.
Yes, I was.
Oui.
Did you know who Tamok was?
Savez-vous qui était Tamok?
Response. I did not know him.
Je ne
I
le
knew
connaissais
of
pas.
Him.
J'avais juste entendu parler de lui.
I don't know where he was born.
Mais je ne sais pas où il est né.
Did you understand what his position was when
Est-ce
you joined
vous saviez
the revolution
quel était
in Tramcock
son poste lorsque
in 1970?
Vous avez rejoint la révolution en 1970 dans le district de Tramcock? Réponse.
Response. No, I didn't.
Non.
When I joined the revolution,
lorsque j'ai rejoint
I did not
la révolution,
work with Tamok. I worked
je ne travaillais pas avec
with
Tamok.
Other people,
mais bien avec
and I did not know where he was, what he did.
Et je ne savais pas où était Tamok ni ce qu'il faisait.
Did you know
Question.
He was from the same
Est-ce
district as you?
Est-ce que vous saviez qu'il venait du même district que vous?
Response.
Réponse.
No, I didn't.
Non.
I didn't know that Tamok
je ne savais pas
was from the
que
same
Tamok
district.
Venait du même district que moi.
Because he could have been living in a different commune,
Peut-être
although within the same Tramcock district.
Dans une autre commune de ce même district de Tramcock.
Who was
Question.
It that assigned you? You testified yesterday that you moved to Kampot and became a member of the Sector 35 committee in either 1973 or 74. Who was it that assigned you to move from Tramcock district to Sector 35?
De quitter le district de Tramcock pour aller dans le secteur 35. Réponse.
It was not Tamok who assigned
Ce n'est
me.
Pas Tamok
It was another
qui m'a dit de le faire,
who already passed
mais
away.
Bien quelqu'un d'autre.
No, but
Il s'agit d'une personne qui est décédée.
He assigned me to work at the sector in Kampot. I don't recollect his name. He's a man.
Assigné cette tâche. C'est un homme, mais je ne me souviens pas de son nom.
He passed away.
Il est décédé.
Perhaps Tathon.
C'est peut-être Tathon.
Again, he deceased.
Mais je le répète.
And he asked me to
il
work
est décédé.
In Kampot.
C'est lui qui m'a demandé de travailler à Kampot.
Tathon. Yes.
Je crois
I think
bien que c'est
I can
Tathon.
Remember his name
oui.
now. He
je
must be Tathon. But he's
Ça doit
deceased.
Être Tathon, mais il est mort.
Now you've testified
Question.
That you joined the revolution
vous avez dit
in 1970.
Que vous aviez adhéré à la révolution
Does that mean that
1970?
You also became a member
Est-ce que
of the Communist
que vous
Party of Kampuchea in
1970?
Or did 1970? That happen later?
Ou bien est-ce que cela a été plus tard?
Response. I was a member of the party in 1970. I don't know before 1970 or after 1970.
Je suis devenu membre du Parti communiste du Cambodge.
I cannot
soit
recollect,
1970,
but I was a member.
Soit en 1970.
I don't know just
je ne sais pas exactement à quelle date.
1970.
Mais je suis devenu membre, soit avant 1970, soit après.
Now, you told my colleague Question. Yesterday that
Hier,
you did not remember
mon confrère
who introduced you to the revolution or the party.
Qui vous a fait entrer dans
but in your
la révolution
first interview with the investigators from the office of co-investigating judges. You testified that you were introduced to the revolution by your cousin.
C'était votre cousin qui vous avait fait rejoindre les rangs de la révolution. Un certain Hem.
Was that testimony truthful?
Est-ce que
were you introduced
vous
to the revolution
avez dit la vérité?
By your cousin?
Est-ce que c'est votre cousin qui vous a fait entrer dans les rangs de la révolution?
Response. I am sorry. I think
je suis désolé.
My apologies my cousin was actually the person who introduced me into the revolution.
Qui m'a fait entrer
the
dans
person
la
named
révolution.
Ham. He
il
was
s'appelle
deceased,
Ham.
Although his wife is
depuis
still
il
alive.
Est mort,
he died
mais sa femme
of
est encore
sickness.
En vie. Lui est mort de maladie.
What was
question.
His position or role in the party at
son
the time
poste,
he introduced
son rôle
you?
Dans le parti au moment où il vous y a fait entrer.
Response. He held no particular
role
at the village. He was leading a small group of people.
Il dirigeait un petit groupe de gens
was
au village.
A village chief. And
il était chef
when
de village.
I was his I lived with his family. I was about 13 or 14
Moi,
years old,
13 ou 14
and
ans,
I was introduced by him
famille,
to join the revolution, although I was too young to know
dans les rangs de la révolution,
what the
même
revolution
si
of the party was back then.
Trop jeune pour bien savoir ce qu'était la révolution et ce qu'était le parti.
Okay, I'm glad you mentioned that because I was a little confused by when you said yesterday that you were very, very young when you joined the revolution. You told us that you're 67 years old now, which by my calculations means you would have been around 25 years old in 1970 when you joined the revolution. Were you 13 or 14 when you joined the revolution, or were you closer to 25 years old?
Plutôt 25 ans quand vous êtes entré dans la révolution.
Response: I'm afraid I don't remember the details because it was very long time ago, and I don't remember how old I was when I joined the revolution.
L'âge que j'avais quand
and
je
I myself am not clear due to the fact that this event
ce n'est pas clair
was
dans mon esprit.
Happening long time ago and I was
tout
not really interested in this.
Or
I was not interested to keep any record of the date when I joined the revolution
or the
year
of
my age back then.
Ou même de mon âge à l'époque.
And you told the investigators of the from the court that you were born in 1947. Is that the year you were born in?
Est-ce bel et bien l'année de votre naissance?
Response. Yes, it is. If I said 1947
si
in that paper, it must be correct. Although I don't remember all, I think it is true that
je
I was born
pas
in 1947.
De tout, mais je crois bien être né en 1947.
And you also told my colleague yesterday
question.
That you were never given any documents to study
vous avez dit à mon
regarding the policies
vous
of the
jamais
party.
De documents pour étudier
but in the statement that
parti.
Your first statement that you gave
dans la première
to the co-investigating judges, you justified as follows.
Vous avez dit, je sais,
quote, question,
question,
were there pagodas, monks, and religious practices?
Pagodes, des moines, des
answer, at that time, there was a disseminated booklet,
à l'époque, il y
and there
avait
were no monks and pagodas. And I'm reading from
D34/4,
English ERN 00364084, Khmer ERN 00357514, French ERN 00403127. As you previously testified, did you receive a booklet
comme vous l'avez dit,
regarding
donc,
party policy
un tel
on pagodas and monks?
Sur les politiques du parti relatives aux moines. Bon.
Yes, at that time, I received a booklet about the pagoda, and I read that booklet.
Je l'ai lu.
But I do not remember the detail, but I do not actually remember whether or not the book mentioned that there was a policy of eliminating pagodas or so.
And
I at that time thought to myself that, well, if there was that policy, that's fine. If it was actually enshrined in the policy, I have nothing to say. I simply follow. But if the upper echelon says there won't be any pagoda allowed, then I have nothing to say. I simply follow. The President, Mr. Canavas, you may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. I understand it's time for the break, but I wish to just make one point of clarification. Twice now, the gentleman on the prosecution side has referred to the statement and has indicated to the witness that she testified. It's my understanding that a statement that might have been given to an investigator is not testimony. It's a statement, so I would prefer if we have some guidance. Are we to refer to a statement as testimony when we are confronting a witness with such a statement? It does tend to cause confusion. It also may tend to elevate
the
nature of the statement itself. My understanding is testimony is what comes from the court itself. I could be wrong, but I don't believe that testimony comes from a statement, especially when the witness, in giving the statement, was not under oath.
Le témoin, lorsqu'il a fait cette déclaration, n'avait pas prêté serment.
If I may respond just briefly, Mr. President,
si
the witnesses were under oath, as indicated in the statement, and I think any statement given under oath qualifies as testimony, but this is a matter of semantics, but it certainly is incorrect that witnesses the assertion that witnesses were not under oath is incorrect.
She was under oath when she gave the statement. C'est faux. Elle avait prêté serment avant de faire sa déposition dans le juge d'instruction.
Le président. Lead co-lawyer is now on her feet. You may proceed if you have any issue to raise.
Vous avez la parole.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Juste pour ajouter une précision, il s'agit d'un procès-verbal d'audition fait par le juge d'instruction, qui est une pièce de procédure couverte par l'ordonnance de clôture. Donc, je crois qu'on peut en faire état tout à fait normalement. Et c'était évidemment une déposition du témoin avant celle qu'elle fait à l'audience, et qui a tout autant de valeur, bien entendu.
Made by the witness prior to these hearings and is entirely valid. Thank you, Your Honor.
The President. Is there any reply you want to make, Mr. Canavas?
Thank you, Mr. President. I do stand corrected. I do notice that the statement was given under oath, but I still maintain that it's not testimony. It is a statement. So I stand by my objection.
En anglais, statement. Et je maintiens mon objection.
The President,
je vous remercie.
Thank you. It is now appropriate to take a short adjournment. The chamber will adjourn for 20 minutes, and we will resume at 11.
20 minutes et reprendra à 11 heures.
Court officer is instructed to bring the witness to the waiting room and bring her back before the chamber, before 11.
Pour 11 heures.
The counsel for Nunchi is on his feet. Do you have any other matters to raise?
La défense de Nunchi.
Mr. President, is tired and request to be transferred to the holding cell so that he can follow
pouvoir suivre l'audience depuis la cellule de détention provisoire au sous-sol.
Hand over the request of the waiver.
je vous remettrai le document de renonciation aussitôt qu'il l'a signé. Le signe.
The counsel for Yang Sari, is there any issue you want to raise? You may proceed. Mr. Ang Udom.
Maître Ang Udom.
Mr. President and Your Honours, since my client has severe back pain,
mon client souffre de maux de dos.
I would like to, on his behalf to ask for your leave
en son nom
to
demander à la chambre
let him follow the proceeding from the holding cell downstairs. He has expressly waived his right to participate directly in this proceeding
for the whole day. À l'audience et ce pour toute la journée.
The President. Upon receiving the oral request
merci.
By the defense for
Nunchia
and Yang
Sari,
who waive their rights to participate directly in this hearing, but instead follow the proceeding in the holding cell due to the ailing health of the accused, the chamber grants the request made by the counsel for Nunchia and Yang Sari, who submitted to the chamber that they have expressly waived their right to participate directly, but instead follow the proceedings from the holding cell downstairs where the audio-visual equipment is linked for the two accused to follow the proceeding. The chamber advises the two counsels that you should hand over the written waiver of rights with the fingerprint from the two accused
document de renonciation
and hand over them to the chamber urgently. And the technician is also instructed to make sure that the audio equipment is linked so that the two accused can follow from the holding cell downstairs. The court officer, the security guards are now instructed to bring the two accused to the holding cell and make sure that the equipment is linked for the two accused. The court is now adjourned.